Well, it was August 2015 when a Hawker Hunter jet, piloted by Andy Hill, crashed on the A27, killing 11 men. Hill has been charged with manslaughter and appears at the Old Bailey in the new year. In the meantime, people in the Shoreham area, around about Ada, have been looking at a fitting memorial. And today we're at a foundry to meet the artists who have been given the job of putting this fitting memory together. We're with Jane Fordham and David Parfitt, who are the designers, the architects, the artists behind this amazing sculpture, more than sculpture, for the victims of the Shoreham Airshow that took place, of course, in 2015, August 2015, in fact. Mm. 3 years in the making. How long have you actually been working on this?
Just over 2 years.
About 2 years.
Because it's a long process of change and adapting.
So how did you actually get involved in this? Did you have to put a bid in?
Yes, it was a competition. We were asked to present ideas, and actually, along with other artists, there was a shortlist drawn up and people were put ideas in. But we actually, rather than putting in an idea for a finished item, we put in a proposal to a method of developing the work from all the things that were important to the project, mm-hmm. like the sites that were available, the nature of the river, and also the men. We at that point we couldn't possibly know exactly what effect that air show had had on the community or the families. Mm-hmm. So we've been on a learning curve since then, and we've learned a lot about how this tragedy has influenced so many people. And because we proposed a method, we've been able to, we hope, reflect at every stage what we find.
We're sort of discovering and learning always as we go. Yeah. It's not a formula that you can apply when you're doing something like this. You know, we've never done work like this before. Because it's so extraordinary.
That's interesting you say that. So you've worked together obviously for a long time. Mm. Yeah. So whose idea has come forward? You sort of, you mix your ideas and bounce off each other all the time?
We actually started with a sheet of paper on the kitchen table, mm-hmm. and we had a conversation over about 4 weeks, and we just kept adding nuances and ways of thinking. And that actually kind of emotional ways of thinking, how we responded to not only that event, but also the river and the environment, and how people grieve. We were talking about how we thought people did that, and which is why we wanted to do something that was making a space for people to do what they needed to do.
And it's our job, in a way, to find the commonality. What people actually want, and somehow make it real, and so that everybody can feel they have a stake in this, and that it was made for them.
There's many changes.
Loads.
Yep. We've got piles and piles of drawings that are just very small details of change. You know, the benches have gone through.
Yeah, many changes.
I don't know them, but there's probably about 35 different bench designs. And then we came up with one that everybody seemed to really like. And then the site changed because of the Environment Agency flood defence, which meant that we had to use that as a starting point and then alter it. So now we've made it integral with where it's going to go now.
Yeah. That is an important part of a major part of the change, which is when we proposed this, the river at Shoreham was a nice windy little place where people sort of walked, and there was loads of buddleia overgrowing it, and it was a texturally fascinating place. It's now quite a man-made environment, and it's completely changed the atmosphere. The thing we have in mind is that give it 20 years and actually it's going to be more like it was. It's going to,
of course, yeah.
The corners are going to get knocked off it, and it's going to get rougher. So We're
looking
planning
to the future, because we're making it to last that long. Yeah. You know, it will last way into the future, and the landscape will grow in around it.
What we've got to consider actually is more important. This is going to be there for at least 100 years. We're aiming it to be there for at least 100 years. If we rush the curing of the cement, if we if we take shortcuts on the personalisation of these arches, it will be regretted for far longer than it will save by getting it out a week quicker.
And so also when we've, you know, again, us getting to know what this project means, we've realised that actually the memorial is not just an object. The memorial is people talking and, you know...
As a catharsis, isn't there?
Yeah. And that is a big part of this for some individuals.
Yeah.
So we've got 11 arches, and I assume each arch represents each victim. Are they going to be individual arches, or is it you just got 11 arches? Or
it's a colonnade of 11 arches. Mm-hmm. So, yes, each arch is absolutely distinct and unique. But they're within very close proximity of each other. So when you arrive on the site, or as you approach the site, you'll see a cluster of arches, which is actually a colonnade of arches, which incidentally echoes Lancing College, which you can see from up on the cycle path. So there is a sort of architectural precedent in that environment already, which we were quite happy with, because, you know, from the point of view of respecting the nature of that area, we weren't imposing something shocking.
That's Jane Fordham and David Parfitt, the artists behind this pretty amazing memorial. It's going to take many months to actually install and be in situ, not far from the airport where this terrible crash happened in 2015. I'm Mike Mendoza for Latest TV News.